Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining in. I hope everyone is doing well and are safe. I'll quickly introduce myself. My name is Divya Poswal. I've been working with Google for almost 4 years now. I'm a territory manager for West India. I'm focused majorly on new business acquisition and have been primarily working on taking G Suite to our customers. I've seen the product, you know, growing with the new advanced functionality being added on almost weekly basis. So today we'll be discussing how we can enable working from anywhere with G Suite, which is the core strength of our product. These are the speakers for today. That's me in the first picture. And we also have Amol and Imran. They're part of Sears, who's Google Premier partner for almost last 10 years now. Okay, so the agenda for today looks like we just done with the guest introduction with the overview of remote working. We'll also do a product demo, which Imran and Amol will help you with. And also Amol will talk about some of the customer success stories for the customers who are already on G Suite with us, right? You know, we'll start with, as we all know today, workplace has become more diverse, right? More dynamic and distributed than ever before. Industries and businesses are being disrupted by new and agile players. And we need to transform digitally to become relevant. That's the new truth which we all are facing today, right? So how do we stay on top? The only solution which we have right now is to get people along information and application together to reimagine how we used to work and how we are working as of today. So let's acknowledge why all of you are here today, right? Regarding the current scenario, you've been hearing a lot about how G Suite can help you, your business, while remotely working from home, as that has become the new normal today. Or you're just evaluating different service providers who can help you better in managing work from home for you all. So G Suite is an integrated solution that includes a lot of applications underneath that, right? It is majorly divided into three parts. One is under the communication, and then collaboration comes in, and then the control comes in, right? Under communication, where you have your customer business email, we have integrated calendar with us. We have chat, Meet to manage your task and time effectively. And under collaboration, we have apps like Docs, Sheets, Slides, Drive, and few more health applications to help you manage your data and create and collaboration in real time, which is the need of the hour right now. And in under control, we have a lot of application which includes very, very strict compliance and regulations, which helps you to secure your data in your company. And you can use the same application for archival purposes also, which includes Google Vault. So these are majorly the applications we have as of now. We are all going to discuss these applications in detail at the time of product demo also. So guys, I'm going to take like 5 minutes on this slide. Because this is really, really important for everyone right now as we speak, for all the businesses, right? So when we talk about collaboration, let's now focus on remote working, because that is how everyone is working today, right? No one is going to offices. So the best solutions for remote working are those which are able to give your employees a very secure work from home environment that enables them to work almost the same way so that they would work in office, right? So with G Suite, you already know that we have all the basics in place. We have a secure native cloud solution, which is easily accessible from outside office, both on your laptops and your mobile devices. The beauty of G Suite remote working comes from the integrated set of apps that we are able to provide to our users. As mentioned on top of the slide, if you can see, we need successful transition to remote work requires more than just video conferencing, right? Or real-time chat. It requires a lot of other things, which includes your secure and integrated solution that helps people collaborate and communicate wherever they are. So this becomes really, really, really important as everyone in the country is working from home or remotely working from their offices, right? So remote working is just not video conferencing, but a suite of products enabling your employees to collaborate and communicate. Let's now go to a normal working day in an office, right? We'll just take a small example here. You have a mail from your CEO that is, that there is an urgent project with you, which could be like a customer proposal or an IT roadmap or a financial analysis for your investors, which needs to be finished today. what will you do in an office setting is that first you'll open your email, you will send an email to your team that there is a project deadline, which is by end of the day. You will send the draft to your team, and then you keep a meeting where you all discuss the project and how's your project looking like, and if there's any changes to be made, or you would like to discuss your ideas on a whiteboard session in an office setting, right, with your team members and brainstorm on the same. Now in the office, you have the access to reach to your team as everyone is available, right? You can just walk up to them and talk to them about the same. You can send document to each other's and manage versions and then finish the work. Now this is how a normal office scenario would look like to everyone, right? Now how would that work if you're working from home? Now let's imagine the same scenario when you're remotely working from home with G Suite. You have the advanced mailing capabilities through Gmail. But now after checking your mail, you can check your team's calendar. You can have a group created for your team to make it easy to work with them, right? You can set up a time to meet and close the same project. You create a Google Doc, which we just talked about in the previous slide, and share it with all the people who need to work on that project. You tag them in and assign tasks to them. And now most important is the real-time collaboration, as you can't be in front of each other. So the real-time collaboration enables you to see all the work happening on that document in real time without managing different versions of the same document, right? Now you can chat simultaneously on the doc, where we have a chat option for everyone, or you can also create a room in the Hangout with your team and discuss the same. Or you have a specific ask for someone, you can leave a comment for that specific person in that Google Doc, right? So that is how usually we all work, right? So as a Google employee, that's how we also work. If, for example, right, working for this webinar, right, we had this slide. We had just created one slide and everyone worked on that slide together. We did not create like 5-10 different versions of the slide, and everyone kept editing and left comment for someone who had a task to do, right? So that is how collaboration works with G Suite. In terms of communication also, right, like I said, right, we have Google Chat, we have Google Meet, where you can just go and talk to your team members in real time, right? Now in a work from home scenario, we can't just drag our chair to our nearest cubicle to your team member and just ask them that, you know, what is they think about this project or something like that. So most SMBs in India are not equipped for work remotely. That is the harsh truth we all are facing right now, right? Working remotely is not possible on your on-prem infrastructure as of now. It is also very challenging with the slow performing cloud solution. So people are getting, you know, taking their desktops at home, which is not a, you know, real-time scenario for everyone who can do that, right? So people are also, you know, getting into video conferencing solution like WhatsApp groups or official work, but that is not secure, right? You're jeopardizing your data in that case. Your customers will not be comfortable knowing that data is being routed through these unsafe solutions, right? So that's where the security part of Google G Suite comes in. At Google, you know, we take security very, very seriously. G Suite is a very highly, you know, secure, reliable, and compliant suite, which you can trust. We are deeply invested in ensuring that our customers can effectively manage users, devices, access, and threats, all from a single admin console, right? We will show you that in the demo, that how you can do that. And we also have a built-in intelligence to streamline notification and make proactive recommendations in that too, right? In this slide, as you can see that we secure email is an area which Google takes great pride in, right? Machine learning helps Gmail to block spam messages and phishing messages with almost 99.9% accuracy, right? We also have built-in defenses against ransomware and malware, and we block almost million of additional emails that can harm users, right? In devices, and we have around 85 million plus devices under management. So all the features which we had just discussed about, which I just talked about in previous slides, everything you can use on your mobile devices also, and it's very easy to use, right? You don't need your laptop to do the same thing, right? Lastly, I'll just take few minutes on this slide. This is very, very important for, I think, a lot of you, right? A lot of people use Microsoft or Salesforce in their daily-to-day life, right? Okay, so we are an open platform and we work seamlessly with other business applications. for your employees, which they use every day, right? For example, our deep integration with Salesforce make it easy and make it simple and very easy to move data back and forth between the two applications. And we also integrate very seamlessly with other tools like you're using Microsoft and SAP. Just a quick minute on that G Suite interoperability with Microsoft products. We know that we're in a world where internally, externally, you will have customers where they're using Microsoft products. And we ensure that we work seamlessly with the people who want to continue to use Microsoft products, right? The bottom line is that G Suite works seamlessly with Microsoft tools, so you can adopt G Suite without worrying about coexistence with your existing tools and infrastructure. G Suite Calendar, Gmail, and Google Meet can be integrated with Outlook front-end if you have some users who don't want to move to the browser, right? So we have that seamless integration in place already. We also have comment on files like you do on Google Files. It's just not on Office files. We support commenting on different kind of file types. Office editing will remove the major disruptions caused from working with Office files in G Suite rather than having to convert a doc convert to a doc and then convert back to Word. Users will be able to collaborate on Office files straight from G Suite, right? So we have that seamless integration also in place. The aim here is to give everyone the benefit of G Suite real-time collaboration and intelligence features, no matter what file they work on, right? So we are going to show everything in our admin console demo and the technical demo, which we are going to start after this. Now I'm going to request Amol and Imran to start with the product demo.
Thank you so much, Divya. Hello, everyone. I'm Amol. I look after the G Suite product within this year. I'll quickly move on to the drive. Right now, what we have done is we have actually created a separate demo folder for everyone. And you can actually see that there are some certain functionalities Google depends and rather uses a lot of AI and ML functionalities to show your working style, and it connects you to the recent documents quickly. So that they give you functionality of quick access. It also allows me to access all the documents within that folder, right? So we have created few documents and we would like to quickly showcase how it effectively helps you in managing such scenarios where people are dispersed at their locations. They are working not only on email, but equally they are working on other communication channels like documents, like chat, like video conferencing. So files, emails, voice, and video are the major communication channels today, right? And then there are multiple files which drive basically allow you to store at individual user drive. You can create multiple folders where you can have shared folder environment as well. So now if you see, the same folder has been shared with around almost 8 to 10 people. All the activities within that folder, it quickly helps me to understand, right? And also let me know which are the files which are deleted, whether they are available, what are the new enhancements which has taken place in the documents. So if I'm opening, so there are multiple ways, right? So people uses Word, Excel, and PowerPoint on a day-to-day life. We want to tell you that the same solution when we are trying to propose for an email communication as well as a conferencing communication, it also gives me a file storing and file sharing environment. It gives me a documents environment, which is nothing but a Word equivalent. It also allows me to access my sheet data, which is nothing but your Excel, right? And it also gives me a option to create presentation. So I've created a few quick options. Now, one way, the way you can look at it, there are multiple people can actually work on the same document. Now, this document has been created within a team, and I would also request my team if they can join onto that document and showcase how we can quickly work together. Meanwhile, I have actually created a separate sheet as well. Now, Google has implemented AI and ML functionalities with an objective to give individual user more intuitiveness in terms of creating charts, pivots, and everything. Most of the people are aware what is pivot, but they don't know how to use it. Even in today's everyday scenario, everybody is aware about so many functionalities, but they don't use it, right? what we have seen is companies spend huge amount of money on these licenses, but their usage is very limited. 15-20% of the people only uses it. What Google wants to bring that for the enterprise users is some of the AI ML functionalities, such as explore functionalities. Now, there is some data you could see. So this data basically talks about a sales review within a company, which we have demo company we have created called ABC Company, right? And we want to showcase that there are so many sales reps are there across different regions. There were their targets and their monthly achievements have been captured in one sheet. Now, as the data grows, you have a quick option to basically identify how does it basically look like, right? As a dashboard or as a report, I can plug in, I can quickly open up and drag and drop it into my sheet as well. So this is a auto chart which helps explore as a functionality within sheet to create automatically, right? You don't have to involve any technical person in kind of creating such kind of a pivots or such kind of a data. Now, moreover, what is important is the same team, if they are working on a dashboard or some kind of a slides as well, they can simply copy this functionality and put it into a presentation slide, which you want to present into to with your management. I can link this particular slide as well. So this allows me to capture all the data point which I'm maintaining at the backend here in the slide or in the sheet, right? Now, any changes you make it here, right? That will basically change the entire spec structure or entire field. And the same thing even happens out on the slide as automatically. So can you see that? What Google Drive gives you the functionality to work very effectively on multiple documents. And the best part is, these are not the attachments which are flowing. As Divya told you in the initial stage, where all these documents are linked, right? They are not the attachments. So if you are sharing a link, you can quickly share such links. Let's say now I am sharing this particular link in my group chat. So let's say I have created one webinar group as well. And here what I would do is I'll quickly share the screen. Rather, I'll share this document with all the people. Now, how many people are there in this? You can quickly see that there are around so many people we have added, around 8 to 10 people we have already. I would want to integrate on these particular documents, right? I can quickly want to see share my other documents as well, which are related to the project, right? We can create group messages, we can create rooms, we can even use bots within Google Chat. So these are the functionalities like Slack or for that matter Teams, and so many other products are there in the market is available. But what Google wants to propose here with chat and all these applications is all these data points can come under one roof and under one domain with an very, very strong admin console, right? So admin console management would be quickly taken up by Imran in next couple of minutes time. But if you could see here, this chat, it also allows me to integrate with my drive. So I can pull the documents from my drive as well. I can even upload some of the documents which are there in my machine, right? Or I can quickly create a video conferencing with a single button and ask everyone to join in this video call. Now, this is the same need which we are using it, right? Now, this video conferencing will quickly help me to connect with more people at one go, right? So these are some of the areas which I wanted to showcase from an end user's perspective. These are some of the benefits. I know these are very known products or tools in the market, but very few people understand the usability, and very few people know that it can be even utilized for the enterprise usage as well. Now, I'll quickly hand over my presentation to Imran. Imran, if you can quickly take us through admin console, that will give more controls and more confidence over to the people that these data are more secure from a single admin console, which is again a browser-based interface.
Thanks, Amol. So as Amol mentioned, the different apps as an end user perspective, so there are granular controls from an admin console. In G Suite. So if you can see, this is the admin console of G Suite, where you can see multiple options. With option users, you can kind of create and delete and manage users. You can also restore their data. You can also restore selective emails of the users if they get deleted. You can create groups. You can create organizational unit to have granular control over the organizational users. You can create buildings and resources if you have different rooms and buildings, and they need to be booked on frequent basis. So you can create buildings and resources. You have devices from here. You can manage all your devices, be it mobile devices or Chromebooks. You got apps in which you have Gmail, Calendar, Contacts, Drive, and the other apps, and you have granular controls on them. So we'll quickly see them also. You have security that you can impose on your tenant. You also have reports, billings, company profile, admin roles. You can add domains. You can use the data migration tool within G Suite to migrate your emails specifically. It has got very limited functionality, but however, you can leverage your data migration tool also. You got rules with which you can create DLP rules for security, and you have support. So now we'll quickly go to the apps. This is the app section, the one which is mentioned here and the shown here. So you got six different services within the apps itself. So this G Suite gives you different services within G Suite, which Amol has showed you. I'll come to this part also, but before that I'll have to quickly take you to the different apps which I mentioned here. Additional G Suite services. So these are the core services, and these are the non-core services to which Google doesn't have any support as of today. But you can have 54 different services as an additional services from Google, which includes bloggers, photos, videos, social tools, YouTube, etc. G Suite Marketplace app. So G Suite has its own marketplace, such as the Play Store you have on an Android phone. The same way you have Marketplace, and in Marketplace there would be thousands and tons of applications published. You can simply search them. Some of the applications could be paid applications, some of the applications could be free applications that you can simply install onto your domain and then start using them. You also have SAML apps. So with SAML apps, you can integrate your there are two options. You can integrate the readily available SAML apps with your G Suite, or you can use the custom SAML apps with your G Suite. These apps can be leveraged in order to provision the users and for the SSO. LDAP, you can use G Suite as an LDAP service, as a secure LDAP service for your different LDAP clients. So this can be used as a source of truth for a certain LDAP based applications. So those applications can leverage the identity of G Suite in order to log into the services. Password vaulted app. So this is another feature wherein there are certain applications which may not support SAML or any kind of SSO. So in that case, you can store username and password of those apps. And like Amol mentioned here, you will be able to see those apps here, and you can simply log into those apps with the passwords saved here. So this is a password vault in order to log into these applications. We'll quickly go to this G Suite applications. I think I'll go from here. So, we have got Calendar, Cloud Search, Drive and Docs, Gmail, Google Plus, etc. I'll just quickly cover two or three of them. So in order to manage them, we got Gmail as a app. In Gmail, you got user settings, you got default routing, you got host, authenticated email, manage, safety, etc. I'd like to take you to the safety option here, which gives you a very advanced security. We all know that our domains are prone to phishing attacks, and most of the times whenever there are phishing attacks, our users do not even know that the emails have come from the legitimate senders, or these are the phishing attacks because of the nature of the email. Sometimes the domain name is projected as if it's the real domain name, or the usernames are projected as if the username within the organization. So Gmail itself has got an internal capability, and the safety check is a feature of the Gmail, which actually identifies such emails and the users and kind of block them there and then itself. So there are different settings which you can turn them on in order to prevent such phishing attacks, such as protect against encrypted attachments from untrusted senders, protect against untrusted against attachments and script from untrusted senders, protect again anonymous attachment types in email, recommend auto feature recommended settings automatically, and sometimes if there are links in the shortened URL, so it can be identified and the protected images can be checked, etc. You can also protect your domain from a spoofing based attack. If there is a spoofing based on the employee name by the domain, etc. So these all settings can help in, you know, protecting spoofing on our domain. There is a next app you can say which is a Drive and Docs, because Amol has mentioned that, you know, you can share these drives, these docs within the organization and outside the organization. So of course, the protection and the security is required. So there are sharing settings that you can kind of apply based on your own tenant and the requirement. So there can be a requirement wherein I just want to share my documents within the organization itself, and sometimes I want to share my document just to certain domains, and that too I need to apply based on the user segment. So I can probably create different organizational units here, put the users in the different organizational units, and kind of create different policies out here with respect to sharing settings. So if I can kind of enable these settings, so currently I have enabled these settings to share my files outside the domain, but I can choose to turn it off and I can simply share it within the domain itself, or else I can simply go ahead and kind of whitelist certain domains. So my users of either if from a organizational unit or from the entire domain can send and share the files with these domains only. So such control we can impose onto our drive, docs, sheets, and presentations, and whichever content present in our drive. So that granular functionality we can have. We can also have an approval mechanism within the drive. We can have shared drives settings. So shared drives initially were known as team drives. So you can have different team drives, and you can have different team drive settings here. And you can.
Imran, I have one question.
Yep.
How we can see the advanced security via Security Center as well as the DLP?
Right. So we have. I will touch those things also. Fine. So we can go ahead with the Security Center as Amol mentioned. So we have a Security Center altogether in a G Suite. So we get a dashboard and we can monitor, you know, most of the parameters out here. So let me show you the help article first. Yeah. So in this security, we can explore a lot of these settings here, such as file exposures. What are the files which are exposed externally from our domain, authentication, how many messages were authenticated with DKIM signatures and not DKIM signatures. Quickly, if I would have to show you. So these are the files which are shared, total 248 files were shared, 94 files were viewed. As we have seen that there were certain emails which were authenticated, so there were 72,000 emails which were DKIM signature authenticated emails. one email was not authenticated. There are certain custom rules which are applied within the domain, and there are around 3,000 users, 3,000 emails which were affected with these custom settings. You can even see the detailed report of it. So 262 emails out here with respect to authentication of the emails. If I can scroll down and go back, I can see that a TLS encrypted 74,000 emails were exchanged, and non-TLS based 4 emails were exchanged. You can also see delivery, email delivery, 82,000 emails were delivered, 0 emails were rejected. You can even see, this is a test domain, by the way, so that's why you can see this a small number here. Otherwise, in your case, the number can be huge. Spam filters, you can also see that how many emails have gone into spam folder, how many emails have gone into inbox, with the details, of course. So you can also see who was the recipient, who was the sender, and some of the more details that you can see as you go along and explore, you know, more and more features within Security Center. So you can see even if the spoofing has happened, if you have received any suspicious attachments. So no, we didn't receive any suspicious attachments so far. You can also see if the device password attempt failure or success is there. So if you have configured your devices and some of the users have kind of successfully logged in, or there was a failure, so on and so forth. OAuth apps and OAuth activity, you can also see that. You can also see if the OAuth scope has been granted to different services or no. There are certain applications. So there are certain applications for which OAuth application access has been granted. And that's how you can kind of evaluate who is the user. Okay, so there are certain users who have kind of requested this. These are all admin users. So as I said, this is a test domain, so there are multiple administrators. If you'll again see it, so yeah, user login attempts, user login challenges, failed user login attempts. Can we see that? So yes, we can see that. So there are certain users. So login 4 login attempts failed for Janvi, for Pallavi Dube, 4 login attempts failed for Ashirvad, 19 login attempts failed for these users. You can also see what login types that they were using. So they all were using passwords while logging into the system. If we'll go back and look for more options. So yeah, there are certain DLP incidences that has also happened here. So yeah, there was a drive DLP incidents happened. So something is blocked sharing outside. So yeah, from drive, drive sharing was blocked. However, you can see the incidents happening here, and you have a setting to kind of send an email back to an administrator if such activity happens here. So administrator would also have received an email that some user was trying to share some confidential information outside, and also the activity is marked here. So that's how you have quite great control over this system. And these are options in the Security Center. If we'll move ahead, we have device management. So in device management, if I'll go to the Android management, so we have Android management. So we have got basics and advanced Android management. So we have advanced Android management here. So let's go ahead and see some of the settings of it. I'll go to work profile. So yeah, I got work profile typically as I can have in any MDM provider, and even the more controls out here. So apps and data sharing, regarding that, I can't copy and paste within my containers. So I get a complete container in my phone, and I won't be able to kind of copy paste, and I can't even screen capture. I can't take a screenshots. And that control you can kind of put from here. You can block installation of applications from unknown sources. You can kind of block USB transfer. It's allowed here. User account network controls, user account controls. Yeah. So we can add users in the company owned devices. We can remove users. If we'll go into networks, correct. So we are allowing Wi-Fi, we are allowing Bluetooth, VPN, etc. Under device features, so here it comes your advanced mobile device management. So you have lots of controls into the mobile device management, such as physical media, trusted credentials, microphone, speaker, and pin setting, factory reset. Right.
Imran, thank you so much, Imran. I think these are definitely important ones, and everyone out here, I believe this will definitely add a lot of values from an enterprise grade security, what you expect from G Suite platform. And Imran suggested, so just quick brief, we have enterprise security, we have DLP, we have mobile device management. These are some of the key areas when we are talking about enterprise grade security, what you expect. So now the last part, everyone, it's basically how we do it is, right? So quick brief about CS. We are basically an enterprise partner, as they also introduced. We are associated with Google since last 10 years. And our journey is very strong since last 10 years. We have seen a lot of innovations take place at the product level, and at the same time we have made our team more robust as well in terms of implementing these solutions across industries. We have clients, enterprises associated. We have more than 500,000 licenses are running on our CS panel with for G Suite services, right? So it's a very strong association of 10 years, more than 150 people, professional resources we have who are all certified from Google, be it deployment specialist, be it a change management specialist, business transformation specialist, as well as technical support specialist, and app script development specialist too, right? The kind of investment overall organization.
Amol, your voice is breaking in between.
And can we just move to the next slide, Imran? Oh, okay. Yeah. Is it better now?
Yeah, it's better now.
Is it better now? Oh, okay. Thanks, Vivian. But yeah, quickly, I'll spend hardly 30 seconds here. As we said, we are associated since last 10 years, and consecutive last 4 to 5 years, we have seen that we have been awarded by Google as the APAC partner. And last year, we were the Japan and APAC partner, right? And that is across different products. So G Suite is the main solution, and we have done a lot of investment onto this particular product. As I said, right, certifications are very important, and enterprises also get a lot of confidence when you have a certified resources working on their project. beyond that, we are the first partner in entire APAC to receive the enterprise collaboration as well as work transformation certification. We are equally a partner with Google for Google Maps as well as location-based services. Next slide. These are the clients I'm actually counting through. It's since last 10 years, as I said, 2000 clients. These are the clients across different industries, verticals. When we talk about the scenario when we are everyone is facing today, a lot of enterprises are looking at these solutions as a very collaborative and at the same time more secure platform instead of moving on to the hybrid environment. People, enterprises and IT leaders are considering this more of a solution for their communication collaboration, enterprise or organization-wide solutions. Now, if you could see that there are various verticals, which we have the clients and logos, and that is mix of small as well as mid and enterprise customers. Yeah, moving on to that next slide, you would see that these are some of the deployments which we have done. These many kind of the training sessions we have done through our transformation agents and certified resources. So CS is known as a consulting partner when we talk about G Suite. And enterprises go with CS is from the perspective how we can increase the product utilization more, right? So important is how to utilize these products, right? On a day-to-day life, I'm so much used to my Outlook, I'm so much used to my document, Office, Word, and Word, Excel, PowerPoint. I cannot think beyond these solutions, right? So as a result, G Suite allows these technologies, but CS helps you how to utilize it through the training sessions. So we have workshop-based training sessions. We have online as well as on-site services as well, right? Definitely retention, we can see because customers see that there is a good adoption of the product also. We also provide very robust technical support and help desk services that helps you to manage all the tickets and stipulated service level agreements, right? Moving ahead, if you could see that, how do we do it? It starts with the advisory services. We always see that enterprises, they want to move on a cloud. We identify whether the organization is cloud ready or not. We propose technology solutions. We provide a detailed technical documentation implementation plan that will help you deploy these services along with change management technical support throughout the year. There are project management and dedicated ongoing improvement services which we provide. You would see in the next slide. So this is how do we drive the engagement year on year, right? And that's why we can have 90% of retention with our clients. Now, these are some of the areas very important when you move on a platform like G Suite. It's a change management platform, right? It's not day-to-day product. Most of the companies have been used, but it is very growing. It's really fast growing. 5 million businesses have moved to Google across the world, right? How they can continue to use these products. And that's where we have identified these are some of the engagement approaches, tips and tricks, tools, surveys, right? We conduct, then there are product updates which takes place. We conduct a lot of use case scenarios, and we share this with all our enterprises also. We provide adoption training services, and that basically helps you roll out new functionalities and features at your end user also. And very importantly, moving on to the services and technical support, you would see that we provide dedicated help desk services, be it remote or be it on-site. Whether it is 8x6 or 24x7, both are available. We have investment done on the app script engineers also. We provide those services as a business improvement, process improvement services, right? There are a lot of workflows today in your scenario would be flowing on via email or a paper base that can be digitized and automated through G Suite's own tools. Right. So, for example, HR onboarding can be completely automated via Google Forms, Google Hangout, Google Calendar, and Google Drive. Right. So, how is something which we can definitely deep dive in identifying your use case scenarios and propose these tools only and to make a complete solution around it. Thank you, everyone, for giving your 1 hour today. It was really important. And thank you for reaching out to us. We will definitely connect back to you post the session as well to understand if we can add more value in some of the other areas, not only security or meet what we discuss more, but there are multiple other areas where G Suite basically adds web business benefits, and understand how this can be more effective for your organization. We, as an offer, also provide 30 days free trial for G Suite basis your requirement and your needs, business needs, and definitely can work during these 30 days in more detail, so that you can, we can come up with the right business benefits and solutioning around the solution, so that you can present in front of your management and take a call. Thank you once again for joining in.